Hi guys, welcome to section 2 of the chapter 7. It is the capacitance, and in this chapter we will discuss about the capacitors, charge storage, and the capacitance of the capacitor. And first of all, a capacitor is a device which is used to store electric charge and the energy. So it is a bit similar as the rechargeable battery, but this is not a battery. There is a commonly used one that is called parallel plate capacitor. As you see in this picture, it has, like, if we figure it, we have two plates like this. These plates are made by metal. If you connect it to the battery, this is the capacitor which is store charge or charge. And if it's store charge, that means it's already storing energy. The side which is attached to the positive pole of the battery, it is storing positive charge, and the side which is attached to the negative side of the battery, it is storing negative charge. So this is called capacitor. Now, capacitance is the ratio of charge and the potential difference. We will discuss about that. And first of all, what's the capacitance? The capacitance is the ability of the conductors to store energy in the form of electrically separated charge. So what does it mean? Capacitance, simply I can explain it. It's like a capacity. For example, if you have a jug of water and you have a glass, two glass. The one glass store 0.2 liters, the another glass store 0.4 liters. So the first glass and the second glass, let's say you have a jug of water like this, it's full of water, let's say. And if you want to fill this first maximum, it can hold 0.2 liter. If you want to fill the second glass, it can hold maximum 0.4 liter. So capacitance of the first glass, or capacity of the first glass, 0.2 liter, and the capacity of the second glass, it is the 0.4 liter. So you can focus on the capacitance from this perspective. So every capacitor has a limit of its capacity. It can store energy as much as it is limit. So here, when you look at the first, second, and the third pictures, as I told you, the capacitors, these are the parallel plate capacitors. It's shaped like this. It's made up the plates. That plates means metals. These are the metals. So at the A, our first picture, the metal is the neutral. 1, 2, 3 positive charge, 3 negative charge. And if we attach it to battery, this is the before charging, because the battery disconnected. When you close the switch, the battery start charging it. And from the negative side, this pole is the negatively, this pole is the positively. So which is attached to the positive side, it will charge positively. Which attached to the negative side, it will charge negatively. And finally, after charging, at this side, as you see, there are only positive charge. Here accumulate because of the accumulation of the negative charge. This and this cancel each other. So there are extra negative charge. So this plate cannot charge negatively, and this plate cannot charge positively. And the formula of the capacitance represented by the capital letter of the C, and the unit of the capacitance is the farad, and capacitance equal charge over potential difference. Charge over potential difference. We are going to use this formula in the questions. And next, it is important. And here, can be useful for further questions. Micro, as you know, it is 10 to negative 6 microfarad, 10 to negative 6 microfarad. Pico, it is the 10 to negative 12. Picofarad means 10 to negative 12 farad.
Hi everyone, in this simulation we will discuss about capacitors. As you see, this is a capacitor. Here is the one plate, here is the another plate, so this is called parallel plate capacitor, and it's attached to battery. As you know, this is the positive pole of the battery and this is the negative pole of the battery. And the what potential difference of the battery now, it is zero. If I make it 1.5 volt, 1.5 volt, now as you see, there is a upper part of the plate, there is accumulation of the positive charge, and the lower plate, there is a accumulation of the negative charge. If I disconnect the battery, as you see, the charge are there stable, they are not moving from anywhere, from one to another. So because of that, as you see, because of the charge, there is a energy, there is a stored energy, we can say, between the plates.
And capacitance depends on the size and the shape of the capacitor. As you see in this picture, every single things, they are capacitors. This, or any of those things are called capacitor. There will be various shape of the capacitor. There is not only parallel plate capacitor, there is a different shape of capacitors. Through the size and the shape of capacitor, it is capacitance change. This is expressed with this formula. There is a constant permittivity in vacuum times area of the plate, distance between the plates. So this is used for the parallel plate capacitor. Let's say this is the capacitor. This is the first plate and the second plate. So there is a distance between them. So this is distance and the area of the, like if we draw it like this, surface area of the plate, it is the area, and this is the constant value. So if you put constant value times area of the one plate over distance between the plates, it gives us capacitance of the capacitor.
Hi everyone, in this simulation we will analyze the capacitance depends on what. We will check the surface area of the plate and the distance between the plates. If I turn on the battery, if I make it now, it is almost 0.7 volt here, and look at the here, this chart indicates the capacitance, this chart indicates the place of the charge. So if I increase the potential difference, the amount of the plate charge increasing, but the capacitance does not affect it by the potential difference, because the capacitance depends on itself of the capacitor. So let's drop it zero. And now the capacitance depends on what? The plate surface area and the separation distance between them. Now if I increase the surface area, look at this chart. If I increase the surface area, as you see, the capacitance increasing. And also it depends on the distance between them. If the distance between them decrease, again capacitance increase. So if the distance decrease, capacitance increase. If the plate area increase, capacitance increase. And if the plate area decrease, capacitance decrease. If the distance between the plates increase, capacitance decrease. So area and the capacitance directly proportional, distance and the capacitance inversely proportional.
And here, as you see on the page, C-sphere, it means capacitance of spherical capacitor. It is Q over delta V, that's equal R over Kc. That's enough, I think, for you. Material between capacitors plates and that can change the capacitance. So what does it mean? There will be simulation. In that simulation, I will explain it much more better. Let's say this is the positive side of the capacitor and this is the negative side of the capacitor. So there will be electric field between the plates, isn't it? Because this side charged negatively, this side charged positively. So electric field goes through from positive to negative. So the charge stored or energy stored inside of the capacitor, so that stored energy in terms of electric field. And if we put another material, another things which is called dielectric, and that dielectric is the, it means it is insulator. If you put here an insulator, that insulator or that called dielectric, that dielectric affect or it's changed or it's increased to capacitance of capacitor. That means if you use an insulator, if you insert insulator between the plates of the capacitor, that's gonna change the capacitance of the capacitor. That's gonna increase the capacitance of the capacitor. I will explain it with the simulation. You will see it much more better. Why capacitance change here? It's because when we insert dielectric between the plates of the capacitor, there will be polarization inside of the dielectric. So the negative charge can accumulate at this side and the positive charge can accumulate at this side. So even inside of the dielectric, there will be electric field, but that electric field opposite of the electric field of the capacitor. So electric field of the capacitor in this direction, direction of the electric field of the dielectric in this direction, so they are opposite each other. So if they are opposite each other, that means it will reduce the total amount of the electric field. So if the total amount of electric field reduced, that means it can hold more charge. Because of this, the dielectric increase capacitance of the capacitor.
Hi everyone, in this simulation we will discuss about the dielectric. And the material between a capacitor plate can change its capacitance. So here is the capacitor and here is the chart which indicates us the capacitance of the capacitor. And here is the insulator which is called dielectric. If I insert dielectric between the plates of the capacitor, we might expect that it must increase the capacitance of the capacitor. So let's do it. Look at the green chart. When I'm inserting dielectric between the plates of the capacitor, as you see, the capacitance of the capacitor start increasing. So now clearly we know when we insert the dielectric between the plates of the capacitance of the capacitor increasing. And why it's happened and how it's happened. For example, if we charge the capacitor with the battery and there is electric field between the plates. The upper is the positive, the lower is the negative. So from positive to negative, there is an electric field. And if I insert the dielectric between the plates, as you see, the accumulation of the charge increasing. That means capacitance of the capacitor increase. That means it can hold more charge on the plate. So the effect of dielectric is reduce the strength of the electric field and a capacitor. So inside of the this dielectric, there is a electric field which is opposite of the electric field of the capacitor, so that reducing total electric field, because of that it can hold more amount of the charge.
Now discharging a capacitor releases its charge. Here in this picture, as you see flash of the camera, it is attached to capacitor. So for the flash we need instant and sufficient light or luminosity at a certain time. When you press the button of the camera, it must release its energy as a luminosity. So how does it work? It works with the capacitor. As you know, inside of every camera there is a battery. That battery with the circuit system is attached to the capacitor. So with the energy of the battery, the capacitor charged. When you press the capture button, it releases that charge instantly through the flash. And at that time, when you are capturing photo, the flash turn on. So it's the point here, the discharging process of the capacitor, it is happening very instantly, in very short time. You will take more information about this later in another year. So the one device that used capacitor, it is the flash of the camera, and also another one, the one type of computer keyboard has capacitor that base of it keys. So there are for the parallel plate capacitor, there are two plates. As you see, the one plate fixed at the base, the another plate at upper part which is attached to key. So it is the mobile part, it can move up and down. When you press that key or button, computer recognize that button. It works with this principle, charging and discharging principle. And there will be simulation. You will see it.
Hi everyone. In this simulation, we will analyze the discharging process of the capacitor. And when I turn on the battery, as you see, the capacitor stored some amount of the charge. And now our capacitor charged. And if I connect that capacitor to a light bulb, what will happen? Let's see. As you see, the charge moving through the circuit and it's disappearing as a light energy. This process called discharging capacitor.
Energy and capacitor. So when the capacitor charges, that means when the capacitor store a charge, the charge is the electrical charge, and if there is electrical charge, there is the electrical energy, we can say. So that energy called electrical potential energy. And the formula about that, it is half potential energy of the electric equal half Q times V. As we discussed before, C equals Q over V, so Q equals C times V. Q is the stored charge, C is the capacitance of the capacitor, V is the potential difference. And if we insert instead of Q, C times V, what will happen? Potential energy electric will be half instead of Q, C times V times V. So it will be half C times V squared. Also we have another form of it. Potential energy electric equal again half Q times V. Now instead of v, throw this formula C equal Q over V. So V equal Q over C. Instead of V, that means potential difference, I will substitute Q over C, so PE will be equal half times Q times, instead of V, Q over C, so it will be half times Q square over C. So we have 1, 2, and 3 formula. They are all giving same answer, same result. It is, they are all for the potential, stored potential energy of the capacitor, and they are expressed here also. So first formula, second formula, third formula. Due to given, as you see in this formula, we have Q and V. If the given is Q and V, you can use the first formula. If the given is C and V, you can use second formula. If the given is Q and C, you can use the third formula. Any formula you can use for any question about this part. Now there is a sample problem. That sample problem says a capacitor connected 12 volt battery. We have a 12 volt battery that holds 36 microcoulomb of charge on each plate. What is the capacitance of the capacitor? So it's asking what is the capacitance of the capacitor and how much electric potential energy is stored in the capacitor. So it's asking potential energy of the electric which is stored inside of the capacitor. And now, what are the givens? The 12 volt battery, that means potential difference is the 12 volt. And what else? We have a 36 microcoulomb. Coulomb is the unit of the charge. So the given is the charge, 36 times 10 to negative 6 coulomb, we can say. And what's the formula of the capacitance? Capacitance equal Q over V. So Q is the 36 times 10 to negative 6. V is the 12, so it will be 3 times 10 to negative 6. And what's the unit of the capacitance? It is farad. And what about the potential energy of the electric field? Potential energy of the electric field. Now we have potential difference, we have charge, and we have capacitance. So from the previous part, we have three formula for it. We can use any one, but this is the most common used in the questions. Half CV square. So half C is the 3 times 10 to negative 6. V is the 12 squared. So the potential of the electric will be 2.2 times 10 to negative 4. And unit of the potential energy is joule.